is Carrie Ann with our Dress Hot Teen Talk. Coming to you this week again from, some of them are outside, some of them are still inside, and we are all in the yellow now, so we are getting closer to green, so yay for us. And the Dress Hot Bridal Shop is still closed due to being inside the mall, but as soon as we get open, we're going to have one heck of a party, so stay tuned to that. So we have a special guest with us today. We have Miss Marissa, who owns the Whimsical Wardrobe Boutique. And she is a clothing truck that sells clothing outside of her own little truck. And that is something that is trending nowadays, is to have your own little clothing truck. So let's welcome Marissa. So hi, Marissa. How are you?
Hi, Carrie. I'm doing good. Thank you so much for having me on. So like Carrie said, I have the Whimsical Wardrobe Boutique. I just rebranded my truck name this year, actually. I used to be called the Vintage Valet. So since 2013, for the last 6 years, I was the Vintage Valet, and now I am Whimsical Wardrobe Boutique. So I am looking forward to getting out on the road.
Well, that's exciting, and I really love your colors, because as you know, Dress Hot is hot pink, black, and white, so we mesh very well together. So fabulous truck looking there.
Thank you. Yes, we do. And if you couldn't tell, I love the color hot pink.
It's a fabulous color. Fabulous. Everybody should have a pair of hot pink pants or hot pink top or something hot pink. Hot pink lips. That's good, right? So Marissa, tell us, you said you started your fashion truck in 2013.
I did, yeah. So I actually had come up with the idea when I had went back to school at the Art Institute. It was in one of my classes. It was actually in an e-commerce class, so it wasn't even a fashion class. And I kind of tell people that's when I had my light bulb moment, where, you know, we had to work on a project and we had to combine, you know, kind of merge our hobbies with our majors. I've always been into fashion and retail for many years, and I was going back to school for fashion, retail management, marketing. So, you know, the idea kind of just went off in my head that I wanted to bring a store to people, and I thought, you know, what if I can just travel around and, you know, bring clothing to people? And, you know, I started looking online and Googling. And it wasn't an original idea, because girls on the West Coast were doing this idea in 2010 of a fashion truck. But, you know, I just was so excited and so passionate about it that I knew by the time I graduated that this was what I wanted to do.
Well, that's excellent. And we've known each other since we worked together at Kohl's in the South Hills. So it's been a while.
It has been a while. Yeah. So I was so fortunate to meet you while we were both working full-time and both doing our businesses full-time. So it was so nice to meet a fellow entrepreneur.
Yeah, we both shared the stress. It's all good, though. All good. So tell me, what is your inspiration behind your boutique and your clothing line that you carry?
So my inspiration, I would say, comes from nature. I have a lot of floral prints, a lot of embroidery, a lot of lace and crochet, like a very romantic, feminine, girly girl, as I like to say. So I kind of get my inspiration from nature, you know, with flower gardens. A lot of my clothes are kind of reminiscent of what I like to say, like a secret garden. So that's kind of where I draw the inspiration from.
Oh, that's cool. Well, we do have some of the girls that are going to wear, that have worn some of your clothing today, and they're going to do a little fashion show. And you're also going to show some extra items that you do carry in your boutique, so anybody can go online. And you do have a website, correct?
I do. It's whimsicalwardrobeboutique.com.
And then they would be able to purchase anything right off your website, as well as contact you if there's something that they are looking for that you may have, because not everything is on your website. Is that correct?
That is correct. So if you're on Facebook or Instagram, also I post a lot of, you know, a lot of my merchandise on there. So if you don't see something on the site, then you can just, you know, email, text, message me, and I can let you know how much something is, what sizes I have. Sure.
And then what sizes do you go up to? Like, where do you start? What sizes do you run?
So I started a size small, and I have small, medium, large, extra large. And then some of the brands that I have carry a 1X and a 2X. And that's something that I am working on, is trying to get, you know, a full size range of all different sizes this year. That is what I was focusing on at the beginning of the year, kind of when the coronavirus hit, as I was going to a trade show in New York. So I know that that is what customers want. You know, you want to be able to find all different sizes for, you know, from extra small to a 4X. So that's in the works.
Well, that's good, because that's what everything that Dress Hot stands for, is that we want every female, regardless of size, shape, you know, color, to be able to find something that they can put on that's going to fit them and that they feel good in it. Because let's face it, if clothes make you feel better, you know, just like even, you know, getting up and, you know, fixing your hair, putting some makeup on every Friday, I'm feeling like a rock star, because Sunday through Thursday, not so much, but that's all good. But I think that with clothing, it creates like a positive energy. If you know you look good in it and you find something that fits you, that you're out there ready to take on the world. So we're excited to get to see some of your clothing line as well on the girls, as well as the other items that you have to show everybody.
So thanks. Yeah, I'm so glad you said that, because that's something that, you know, I want to talk about today, is finding, you know, colors that look good on you with your skin tone, you know, that go with your, you know, your eyes and your hair. And then, you know, that there's all different body types. So finding the right style too, that works well.
Yeah. And it's very difficult, because, you know, sometimes they have the trends out there, and not everybody should be wearing those trends, if you can say. I mean, it's good that there's trends, but sometimes people just, you know, go find another trend, you know, because, well, you don't.
You know, everybody should have their own style. So like you said, just because something is trending doesn't mean that you have to wear it. So, you know, you have to have your own style. And like you said, feel good in something.
Yeah, if you don't feel good in like wearing zebra pants, then, you know, just because the animal print's out there, like I am all animal print head to toe. But sometimes if you're not feeling it, you can just tell that trend's not for you. So, but that's okay. But if you can rock it and you feel confident, I say go have at it. But I agree with you. Just sometimes trends are out there. It's really not everybody should be wearing them. So, but let's start with some of the models. And then while you go to get your other clothing, let's start with Kenzie, since she was so excited to be like stepping out of her comfort zone. We just lost her. There she is. So Kenzie, tell us about what Marissa sent you from Whimsical Wardrobe Boutique and how you worked it to you.
Okay, so Marissa gave me this like wonderful vest that it's super cute. It's like, hold on. Okay, so it's like this long, so it's like, it has this little flare, and then it's longer in the back. So I think it's like party in the back and a little fufu in the front. I think it's very cute. So I decided to match it with Jean's white shirt to go. So I thought it would look really pretty with this outfit.
You're rocking that, Kenzie. I really like that on you.
I do too. And that's what's so great about a vest like Kenzie has on, is that you can absolutely do so much with it. It's a great layering piece for any time of the year. Like, she paired it with a little t-shirt. You can wear a tank under there. You know, you can wear it over a dress, like with shorts or Bermudas or capris or denim. Like, it's so versatile.
All right. So you can get like a whole year workout with that, because you can put any type of top underneath it, and not just for summer.
And it's nice because, like, you can see that there's like all different colors in it. And like you can match it with many different styles and colors. So oh, that's what cool. I like about it. Because it's like super silky, but like super nice.
Now, Marissa, what would that run as far as the cost?
So that vest is $79. It comes in small, medium, and large. And, you know, people don't have to get so caught up on the sizes with vests because, you know, it's just an open vest. So, you know, if you normally wear an extra small, a small is going to work. If you normally wear an extra large, a large can work, you know, it's a vest. So that's Phoenix. Another that I like.
Sorry. It's raining in my raining now.
Oh, we have action going on today on our team talk. Always something from Kenzie. Okay. you can't make this stuff up. Oh, let's go to Zoe. We'll be back to Kenzie. Okay, Ms. Zoe, so what do you have going on today? You have to unmute yourself, love.
Oh, that would help. Okay.
Okay, I can hear you.
I also have a vest. It's longer in the back and has a lot of pretty colors. I paired it with a cami and then just some leggings to be comfortable, to be honest. But what I really like about it is there's so many different colors. So you could do like a lot of different camis or long sleeve shirt or short sleeve shirt. It has really pretty detailing and I really like it.
We can turn around, honey, so we can see the back of it. Yeah. Very nice. I like the coloring. Can you push the coloring up closer to your phone there? Mm-hmm. Very nice. Now, Marissa, what would that run?
That vest is the same style as the one Kenzie had on. So it's also $79, just a long lace vest, and it's striped. It has that mauve, olive, black, white. So the vest that Zoe has on really can be literally for any time of the year, depending on what you wear under it.
Yeah, and that, I really like that. I like the colors. It has a little bit of dress talk colors on there. Liking it. I may have to buy me one of those. So let's go to Bethany. Bethany, let's model your your thing there. What do you got? Things flying in the air.
Move my worms real fast. Okay.
It's like I'm in a jungle. What the heck is that hanging down? Is that a pepper?
Wait, didn't you set one on fire?
No, there are worms on a string.
Worms on a string. Okay. Yeah. That'll be for our next session as to why you have worms on a string in your bedroom. But okay. Well, let's get back to the fashion here. So let's, what do you have the model for us?
Okay, so I have a vest and a tank top. And the tank top has like gems up here.
Oh,
and
cool.
Then the vest is lace in the front. And then it's like a flower pattern in the back. And I tucked it into my jeans.
That's very nice. So what would that kind of run, Marissa?
So what Bethany has on is made in the United States, and the tank top is $40. It's ribbed, and it has those little rhinestones at the top, and then the vest is $68. And her vest is a shorter vest. It's not as long as the one that Zoe and Kenzie had on, so it's a shorter vest. You know, some people don't like things as you know so long. Some people like things shorter, so I like to kind of have a variety of choices.
Yeah, even those vests, you can use it like even over top, like basically summer dresses. If you have like a plain summer dress, just to like pop it up.
Absolutely. I mean, what the one that she has on with like the hibiscus and the flowers, I mean, it's very much, you know, summer, but then, you know, you could still wear that in like say September, because you know that's paired with that like burgundy wine color tank, so you can just do a lot with it.
Okay, cool. Let's go with our last model here, Miss Emma. So let's get some excitement on your side there.
I don't have any worms hanging from my ceiling, but I'll try to be exciting. So I have on this baby doll yellow top. I'm trying to like stay in the camera frame. I'm pretty tall and my phone's sitting down, but yeah, it has this like really pretty lace pattern over top. And let me tell you, this is like the comfiest top I've ever wore. Like, I'm not kidding right now. This is so flowy. I can breathe in it.
Cute on you.
Thank you. And I'm like, I'll try and get closer. Yeah, it has like this really pretty flower pattern on it. And it goes all the way down.
Now, what did, does that come in different colors too, Marissa?
Unfortunately, right now I just have that saffron mustard color. But I do love that top. I'm so glad that Emma said it was so comfy because it is, and it's so lightweight. It kind of is just like an elbow sleeve. It's got the lace, and I think the color looks great on her too.
No, that would be something I would wear. I think that is pretty cool. It's just like fun and flowy, and you can eat, and you don't have to worry about, you know, you can hide your stuff. Just kidding.
That's a good quarantine top then is what you're saying.
That's right. So everybody comes out, everybody needs to have the, you know, the top that Emma has on. Okay. Well, how do you guys, so let's talk about, you know, how should everybody like pick colors for, you know, their skin tone? Like what would you recommend? And then we'll go through some of your items in the back behind you.
Yeah, so basically you're finding your undertone is your complexion. So the best, you know, the reason you want to know whether you're a cool, a warm, or a neutral, that'll kind of help guide you to what colors are going to look best on you. So the first way you can start is just by, you know, taking a look at your arm and looking at your veins. So if you see that you have like very blue or purplish veins, then you're definitely going to be cool. If you have more of a greenish vein, then you're definitely going to be a warm undertone. If you can't see your veins, God bless you.
That's me. I was going to ask that question. I don't see any veins at all.
So people say, I have so many veins, you can see them so much. But if you can't see your veins, then you would just go by, you know, your hair and your eye color. So if you have, you know, blue or green eyes, you're going to be typically a cool, you know, undertone. And if you have like brown or hazel eyes, that would make you a warm, you know, skin tone color. If you have, same thing with your hair, if you have, you know, blonde hair, black or red, typically you're going to have that cooler skin tone. If you have, you know, brown, like auburn, you know, the darker hair, you're going to be warm. And typically, you know, stylists will say that if you are a cool undertone, then, you know, you would look better in the cool colors on the color wheel, like blue, purple, green. And if you are a warm tone, then you would look better in like red, orange, yellow, and those shades in between there. Now, you can also be, you know, if you kind of fall somewhere in the middle, then you can just be a neutral, and then great, you'll probably look good in pretty much anything. So for example, I am definitely a cool undertone. I have the very, you know, fair skin, blue veins, blue eyes, light blonde hair. So I am a cooler, you know, skin tone. So typically I would look better in like the blues, purples, and greens and those shades. However, I like to wear just any kind of brighter colors or jewel tones, because I feel if I, like, so right now I have a hot pink dress on. I mean, that's a warm shade with this cardigan with all different colors, but I feel like, you know, if I wear something that's very light or pastel, sometimes that it washes me out, and I like the brighter colors and the more jewel tone colors.
Okay. So Zoe, what are you, warm or cool?
I think I'm cool.
Cool. You're cool. Cool deal. Bethany, what about you, babe?
Oh no.
You don't know? Can you see veins?
I think I'm neutral.
Bethany could definitely say she could be neutral because, you know, she's got kind of like the blondish brownish hair, you know, dark eyes, but her skin looks like the type that, I mean, do you tan easily?
Yeah.
Like you don't look like you're very, very fair skin. So if you're a neutral, then you, any color is going to look good on you. I mean, what color do you feel looks best on you?
Red.
Red. Okay, great. Yeah.
Okay, what about you, Emma?
I'd probably say warm, but a little bit neutral because I do look good in like greens and blues sometimes, but they have to be like a darker shade of green and blue. That makes sense. But I look probably best in like reds. Carrie Ann seen me in a red dress a lot.
Yeah, but you were rocking that, sister. I'd have to say, yeah, you were doing very well. And then Joey, I think you would be, I mean, that royal blue dress that you wore in Pittsburgh Fashion Week, I mean, you looked amazing. And I, you know, so I would say, what's your favorite color, Zoe?
Probably blue. I love blue.
Good. And then last but not least, we got our Kenzie down here. So what are you, warm or cool?
I like wear a lot of blues. But then, like, it depends. Like, I wear a lot of maroons, and occasionally, like, I wear mustard yellow. So I'm just, like, kind of, like, 50-50 on both. Because I wear, like, I don't wear pinks or, like, I wear a lot of grays and blues. So I'm more on the cooler side, I feel like.
Is there, like, a color that you feel like that you wear that you're like, man, I got this. Like, you just rock that color.
Maroon. I look really good in maroon colors and like dark blues, like blue colors.
So those are the colors you feel the most confident
in. Yeah, that's mainly my wardrobe, blues and maroons.
Yeah, I got black and white if you all never noticed because that's the color of the store. So, but no, that's cool. That's awesome. What about you, Bethany? Is there a color that you, whenever you put it on, you just know you're going to have a great day? You have to unmute yourself too.
Like pastel yellows. I feel like when I put those on, I'm like, yes, this is great. I love this. Or like any pastel color and then just like a like wine red.
Ooh.
Okay. You are.
She's got her bucket hats with it. So.
Yes. Yes.
Oh, there. She doesn't have one on today. She did her hair.
I'm sorry.
So, okay, Marissa. So let's see some of the other items that you have behind you so that maybe the girls will be interested or everyone who will be watching our YouTube series would be interested. We're going shopping, ladies, virtual. I know we're not out in the store right now, but we're virtually shopping.
Let's see here. Do I have to keep my phone? Is it best to keep it horizontal?
Yes, just so that you're wider, like your picture's wider.
Okay, so I'm going to try to do this without flipping my camera. But first, I want to show you guys this puff sleeve tiered dress that I have on the mannequin here. Can you see it okay?
Oh, that is so cool.
So the puff sleeves are really, really trending this spring and summer. Like anything with volume on the sleeves, the puff sleeves are really big. I've got a lot of vests here, the one that Kenzie has on, and then I also have that in like a beige-ish color. I've got this dream catcher vest here. So for those of you who...
Move it a little bit towards your camera there. There you go. Now we can see it. Oh, look at that.
Gray and the black. And then it's got like every color on the dream catcher with the feathers there. Let me see if I can flip my camera around. Let's see if I can.
Feathers. I love feathers. Where'd she go? We lost her. Oh, there she is.
Okay. So, and then... I also have this vest is the same style that Bethany had on. This is gray with like a burgundy, yellow, green with a nice white lace. And I've got a denim vest here with white lace. So you can kind of just, you know, throw this over anything. I've got some cold shoulder tops. The cold shoulder is still popular. Animal print, anything floral is really big. So I have a gray and a black tank here that has this beautiful floral trim. This cum size is small to extra, extra large. And here's the black with the trim on it. It's a racer back tank. So you can, you know, wear that by itself in the summer or
can you pull that out so that everybody can see that one?
Yeah. You know, you can wear it by itself or put a jean jacket over it.
That one's pretty cool. And that one goes from a small to extra, extra large?
Yeah, small to extra, extra large. It's $68. You know, good for any time of the year because you can wear a cardigan or a jean jacket over it. I've got a lot of fun tanks with like a lot of detail on the back. So this one's got like this tiered lace and then it ties in a bow. So this is really fun for summer. And this is, you know, for those of you that love the neutral colors. And speaking of neutral colors, I've got this fun tank too. It's solid, you know, brown on the front, and then it's got the detail and the lace, you know, the back here. You can just wear a little cami underneath of that. And of course, I didn't bring everything up. This was just a sampling. I have plenty more, but some fun summer colors. This is a nice, you know, like aqua teal color tank top with the pleats. And it's pleated in the back too. So I have that in teal and hot pink. And then like I was telling you guys at the beginning about like floral gardens and how I'm inspired by nature. I love this cardigan here. It's like a dusty mauve color and it's just got this beautiful embroidery in so many colors on it. It's just like a work of art. And same with this piece here. It's like flannel plaid at the top. And then the bottom just has this gorgeous, you know, fuchsia purple floral embroidery with the leaves. So this is like a really long, fun duster that you can wear, you know, with denim, like whether it's shorts or jeans or capris.
Who says that flannel isn't cool, man? I mean, look at that bottom. That's a lot of detail to that one top.
I know. I mean, this is very, very detailed.
Wow, very nice. How much does that run?
That piece is actually the most expensive piece that I have. It's $205. This runs small through extra large. So, I mean, speaking of price range, too, I really have a wide range from items from $20 all the way up to $200. But I have a good, you know, middle ground where a lot of the pieces are, you know, the average is $68.
Okay.
This here I wanted to point out because a lot of the girls said they liked red. So this is a fun crochet, you know, bell sleeve top with the pleats. You know, it's got a little matching tank top underneath. You can wear that any time of the year. And then just more of like the florals that are very feminine, very detailed, very girly. And this one here with the embroidered lilacs, you know, over this floral overlay. It's just, I love the denim with the bell sleeves on that. That's a lot of fun. And then, you know, I've got another dress here with the puff sleeves, this black dress here, more form-fitting lace. Puff sleeves are really big. And that's the thing, like we talked about earlier too, that, you know, just because puff sleeves are trending doesn't mean you have to wear it. So if you're like, if I don't like the puff sleeves, I'm not, you know, I don't want to wear that, then, you know, great. You should have your own style and wear what you feel best and most confident in.
Right. And I think that, I mean, especially that dress is very fun and flowy. It looks like a lot of your collection is very, it goes a lot with your name, Whimsical, because it's very feminine, very light, very, you know, just airy looking, you know what I mean? I don't know if that's the word to describe it, but it's not like your heavy, typical, it's very unique looking items that you carry in your boutique.
Thanks, Carrie. And yeah, I mean, I think you hit the nail on the head. I mean, it is very whimsical. So, you know, very feminine, romantic, light, airy, flowy, lacy, you know, lots of detail, crochet, pleats, ruffles. So definitely.
Perfect. And then you said a lot of your sizes, they do go from zero to like small to double XL. Some of the items you can't get in bigger sizes, but some of them just go up to large. Is that correct?
That's correct. And so small, medium, large, I have some extra larges, and then some of the brands have, you know, an extra, extra large and a 1X and a 2X. So, you know, I am looking to find more brands that have more of a size range.
Okay. Do you have any, I know with the coronavirus, it has kind of hindered you a little bit as far as where we can see you with your truck. Do you have anything upcoming, you know, that since we're in the yellow a little bit, that you can get out there as long as there's no more than 25 people?
So as of right now, I should be able to still go to the Bethel Park Farmers Market. That is the second, I will be there the second Tuesday of every month. So June, July, August, September. That's from 3 to 7. That is in South Park. So that would be a definite place, you know, once a month that people can find me. And then also I do a lot of the Market Square night markets. We're still waiting to hear from them on which ones are going to be canceled, because those were, you know, those, some of those were in conjunction with like the Three Rivers Arts Festival, which has gone totally online. So, you know, they're still working out different things too, because they do a farmer's market downtown and they relocated it kind of down more toward the convention center out of Market Square. So I think places where I go for these events, they're still trying to kind of navigate how they can have these events and have it be safe for everybody. So as soon as I get confirmation of things, I will post, you know, a schedule on my website.
Okay. So Emma, did you see anything within her collection? Is it like a collection that you would wear, like some of her items?
Definitely the puff sleeve dress. I love puff sleeves. I absolutely love puff sleeves. So yeah.
So that dress that you have on the mannequin, how much does that run, Marissa?
That one, that is $160. That's one of the pricier brands. That one comes small, medium, and large.
Okay. Then what about you, Zoe? Did you see anything that kind of goes with your persona, your fashionist, and everything?
Yeah, I love that one vest with all the embroidery of the flowers and stuff. I love that. It was beautiful.
So perfect. So make sure you guys all catch up with Marissa after this. What about you, Kenzie?
I really like the blue, but like you said, you got the hot blue. I mean, the hot pink and the blue dress thing. That was really cool. Like, I like best, like, flowy stuff. I would. Yeah.
Okay. And then what about you, Bethany?
The one, like, embroidered jacket.
With the floral embroidery at the bottom. Yeah. And that one's really cool.
Love that one.
Yeah, what does that one run?
That was the one that's my most expensive piece was $205. Yeah.
Okay, Bethany, you got high taste there. Holy moly.
You know I have high taste.
You better walk some more dogs, man. She takes all major credit cards, just so you guys know. How funny.
Your budget.
No, I think that one with the one you said it comes in hot pink with the puffy sleeves. I like that one. It was like an accordion. It was towards the end. You know which one I'm talking about, Marissa? Yeah.
Was it like this one here? This I have it in the blue and the pink. It's a
Yeah, that one. That has the sleeves, doesn't it? The puffy sleeves.
Well, this is a sleeveless one. As far as puff sleeves, I've got the dress on the mannequin, this dress here, the black. It's kind of hard. I feel like my lighting is not the best in here to see. But yeah, pretty, like, I have all the, you know, my cardigans and anything with a sleeve down at this end here. Okay. Then the rest sleeveless, but I have a lot more. I just kind of brought up a sampling of things.
No, and that's cool. I think what you brought was a great display of, it goes very well with your rebranding that you have done. And I think it will, you know, once we get back open, I think you'll be very successful. Now, Marissa was going to be a part of our Dress Hot fashion show, our annual fashion show that we have, and we were raising money this year for our Project Prom with Allegheny County. We had to postpone it because it was on March 29th. Now I have rescheduled it for August 2nd. I'm still going to have it. No matter if I have to postpone it again, I am going to have this fashion show one way or the other. I promise everybody that. And we are going to have the fashions of Marissa's Whimsical Boutique as showing her. We have girls who are going to be modeling her fashion. So I think it's going to be an amazing event. And so hopefully August 2nd, we are back in the green and we're able to move forward because we had a lot of girls who were interested in modeling. We had great vendors who were going to be there. There was two other fashion trucks that were going to be there with Marissa. And I really think that with her collection, focuses, you know, it's fun. I mean, I think everybody being stuck inside for these last couple months, it's time that they want, you just feel like you want to get some new items into your wardrobe. You feel like you just want to get some newness into your life because things have been sweatpants, t-shirts. I don't know, that's how my life has been on this side. So my husband just bought a pair of tennis shoes. He feels like he's like a new man. I'm like, okay, but it's all good. But I just think that, you know, if there's something there that you girls liked, or even if you know friends, family members, there's birthdays probably coming up this summer. Certainly, you know, reach out to Marissa, go on her website, take a look at everything she has. I've known her for a while. She is, I consider her a friend. And any way that we can help any small business at this time during this virus is so important. And, you know, we all stick together. And I think that it's a way to, you know, support one another. Certainly she has supported me as well, as that's why she came on today, because I think her brand is, you know, very fun and amazing. And she's just a great person to, you know, work with. So do you guys have any questions for Marissa before we, you know, go off? You guys got the motto a little bit. You did say you were going to go to the store the first time you got out for the COVID. So everybody got to, we shopped for you a little bit and you got the model. And you have a question, Mackenzie?
I have a question.
So okay, thank you.
Do you make like half these clothes? Because you were like saying you get them from different vendors. So that's what I was like, kind of confused on. So do you make these clothes, or the, do you like purchase them from other vendors and then you put your own twist onto them?
That's a great question, Kenzie. I am not a designer. I go to different trade shows and look for different vendors, you know, different brands to purchase to put in the boutique. One of the goals that I wanted to do, that I'd still like to do, is work with local designers to use my truck, you know, my boutique as a platform to carry their, you know, their designs in. So that may be something in the future to, you know, I want to help designers get their collections out to people. So.
Okay. That, yeah, I was just kind of confused. That's super cool. One thing.
Yeah. Thanks. You guys ever known of like a truck that carried like fashions? I mean, that's different. It's unique. It's creative. And I think you're going to see a lot more because it helps out on the overhead, you know, so you basically own the truck and, you know, you get to create, you know, you go to like certain places, you get to meet a lot of people and you're not like stuck in a, you know, one facility for 7 days a week, you know, so that gives her a lot of flexibility. She also does home parties. Is that correct, Marissa?
It is. Yes. I actually put a post out today about it because, you know, now that we're in the yellow phase, you know, we're kind of moving in the right direction. So if anybody wanted to have a home party or have the truck, you know, come to their business, you know, we can definitely practice safe social distancing, you know, standards, just like anywhere else. So definitely.
And I did offer to Marissa once the dress hot shop in the South Hills Village Mall opens back up. She's going to come up for a Saturday, bring her rack in, and we're going to have a little bit. You guys can come up and model her her clothing line for us, and you can be in the windows like you guys did for the holiday. How fun would that be? Yay! So, but I mean, it would be exciting. I am so ready to get back out there, and I'm excited that we're still planning on having our fashion show August 2nd. And the other thing I just announced is that we will also be doing a prom for the dress house. Going to have their own prom at the Crown Plaza on July 31st for the schools that are not able to have their own prom. So we're giving the girls who, anybody who purchased a dress from Dress Hot that's not going to be able to attend their prom, Dress Hot is going to have a prom. And I'm hoping that they allow up to 250 people, because I plan on 300, because Carrie Ann's going to be there and I can get out there on the dance floor and rock it down. But I would like to wear a prom dress too. There you go. So I think that hopefully, you know, spread the word out. All schools are invited. We only have like limited seating because of the hotel, but hopefully by the end of July, they're going to let gatherings happen again so that we can give some of the seniors a prom to remember from Dress Hot, so that they get to wear their gowns and, you know, they at least get something special before they go off to college or start into the real world, we should say, right? So Kenzie, did you do your graduation yet?
No, so I'm doing a virtual graduation June 5th, and then I'm having the actual one August 1st.
Okay, so see, look, your graduation party can be on July 12th now, because I moved the fashion show to August.
And that's the day of Peter Sanchez's prom.
What, August 2nd?
No, July 31st, I think, the day of our prom, of the Dress Hot prom.
Oh, well, there you go. Go to their prom if it's boring and you come to mine.
Your prom's going to be much better, probably.
I can guarantee you that. Carrie Ann knows how to bring it down. But no, that's cool, though. But at least they're getting to still have it. I deliver dresses to girls at Bethel Park. Theirs is, I think, the July 23rd or 24th. That they're going to still plan on having their prom, and hopefully, you know, girls will be able to go. Now, there were some students that their schools totally canceled that they bought dresses. So hopefully they want to attend ours, then we'll be able to at least give them something. But back again, remember August 2nd is going to be our fashion show with Marissa, as well as two other boutiques. A lot of girls are coming, vendors, so we should have a great, and we're still gonna raise money for the prom project, because even though they missed their proms this year, we're able to raise money for them so that they have a great, you know, purchase merchandise for the following year. And, but besides that, we appreciate Marissa coming today and showing us her fashions. Thank you for giving, you know, letting the girls their fashions. If you guys like what you're wearing, then certainly meet up with Marissa and she will work you up a price. And if there's anything else you guys saw in the background, or if you think like your friends would like it, you know, certainly really tell them to go on to Marissa's website, whimsicalwardrobeboutique.com, or reach out to Marissa. You guys all have her number so that, you know, we can really try to support her business, since she's, you know, a small business just like myself, and, you know, just to give her that support during this time of everybody being shut down. So, okay. So anything you have else for my girls or myself, Miss Marissa, before we go, any tips of advice?
Well, I want to thank you so much for having me on. And like you said, I think people now more than ever are going to want to support small businesses, you know, if and when they can. And, you know, just because we are moving into the yellow phase, you know, all of my events still are canceled until sometime in June. And even those are kind of up in the air. So, you know, just like you, you know, we've kind of had to pivot a little bit and kind of focus our efforts online. But, you know, my advice to everybody, just, you know, follow your heart, follow your passions, follow your dreams. You know, you got to do what you love. So do that. Surround yourself with people who only lift you higher. You know, surround yourself with people who are positive and, you know, will help you achieve your dreams.
Okay, well, that's awesome information and awesome advice for everybody. So, see, you guys are all around me. I lift you up higher. Ha ha! So anyways, this is Carrie Ann with Dress Like Teen Talk, and I am so glad you shared the time with us today, and we look forward to seeing you guys next week, same time, same place, and you guys love yourself, embrace your curves, be who you are, and stay safe. Carrie Ann, out!